This is TWiT.
This one kind of came out of nowhere. We had heard rumors that Google was working on some sort of game console. It turned out when they finally announced it, and I don't believe that it's totally out for everyone yet, or maybe you can correct me if I'm wrong, but Google Project Stream is their approach. And like you said, this is all happening in a Chrome browser, right? You played with
in
this.
In any Chrome browser that is on a computer, meaning it's not currently working on smartphones or Android tablets. But if you can boot Chrome, you can start playing Assassin's Creed Odyssey, which is the newest Assassin's Creed game. This is a invite-only beta, and they let a lot of people into the earliest wave of the beta, but not every single person. And part of the requirement was that you had to do sort of a network test, that you reached at least a 25 megabits per second download rate in order to be able to play. So that's a little demanding. That's not just anybody's internet speed by default, but it's also kind of doable throughout in a big city sort of internet way. And it just works. It'll identify whether or not you have a controller connected to the computer in question. And the Xbox One, Xbox 360, PlayStation 3, and PlayStation 4 controllers all have USB options, meaning if Chrome is on and Chrome senses that you have plugged in one of these controllers via USB, it will go, hey, I found a controller, done. And I was absolutely shocked at how smooth that controller connecting was. Wow. That being said, if you just want to do PC and or mouse and keyboard on the laptop that you're using or desktop that you're using, that will also work. And there's a whole control config for that. And from there, Assassin's Creed is a great example of a game that really benefits from a high-powered server in terms of that server's pumping out a ton of 3D data, a giant world with huge draw distances, big open seas, all that sort of stuff. But also, you don't need that exact button crazy, perfect timing kind of slapping of buttons. You may have a crowd of bad guys come up, but you get a pretty forgivable window if they're about to attack you to dodge or roll or get out of the way or block. You'll even get a little bit of Matrix-style slowdown in those situations. So it really does lean nicely into that little bit of latency that you get. And I will say, I definitely noticed a little bit of latency. I'm very sensitive about that sort of thing. But I could totally play the game. It was built exactly with that limitation in mind. It felt totally fine. And it's free until the beginning of January. It's just a free test of Assassin's Creed Odyssey that they're giving away if you can get into the test. So, you know, go. You can head over and sign up. I don't know at what point they're going to just let people in by the droves, but yeah. I was able to get in pretty quickly, and other friends of mine were as well. So it's a pretty decent sign. And we're filming in November, and the test is still going to be live until January. From there, we don't know what Google's going to do. Like, clearly, they've built something that works really nicely in Chrome, so I really doubt they're just going to chuck it in the trash. But it's going to depend on who they sign up, what kind of partners, what kind of games, and on and on. So we don't know that. But we do know one game works darned well on it.